Rafael benítez has lost virtually all trust in my at legitimate at newcastle united and no longer regarding his job as a long-term project would be reasonable alternative offer of employment at similarly size premier league club although newcastle manager will not walk out in the wake of a disastrous transfer window benítez is angry deeply frustrated and ready to contemplate life away from tiny side he came extremely close to taking over at west ham 2 years ago only for the mooted deal to be hijacked by Real Madrid at the T11 hour, but remain much at nearby the London Stadium board, with Slaven Bilic under considerable pressure at West Ham. It is not inconceivable the post could shortly become vacant. Were this to happen, Benítez would seriously consider relocating to London, although Atlee would be expected to fight hard to keep him at Etienne Park. A clause in the 57-year-old contract stipulated that if the Newcastle manager or the club seeking to employ him must pay £5.6 million to trigger his release, and Atlee would be expected to play handball over exit negotiation, with the sport direct owner likely to force Benítez to resign rather than offer a rival club permission to speak to him. Any departure is likely to prove anything but straightforward. Atlee apparent determination to retain the services of a manager was present he believed not only boost Newcastle brand value significantly but can also help him eventually sell the club. Seem at odds with his failure to fulfill the former Liverpool, Chelsea and Real Madrid manager wishes. Despite Benítez cutting the wage bill by around £200,000 a week in the last 6 days, Newcastle failed to sign anyone on deadline day, leaving a manager who no longer believes it will be possible to fulfill his ambition of leading the team back into the Champions League under Atlee administration, without a fit specialist left back. Although Newcastle signed 6 players for a total of around £36,000, 16 departure dictated that net spend on transfer fee was only around £20,000, distinctly modest for a newly promoted club. Such apparent parsimony also left Benítez without an extra goalkeeper, striker, winger and central midfielder. These failures to reinforce the squad represent a high-stake gamble on the part of Atlee who appear convinced Benítez's stellar coaching ability can keep Newcastle in the Premier League. A relegation skirmish was the last thing on the manager mind when, shortly after winning the championship, Atlee promised him every last penny of available fund to spend over the summer, but now threatened to become a reality concern crystallizing June. By then Justin Barn, a lawyer and long-term Atlee confidant, had become heavily involved in club business alongside Lee Chan Lee, the managing director. And delay in haggling over the fine detail of transfer, Benítez's determination to secure the best possible deal for his boss arguably led to Benítez missing out on a season-long loan deal for the Chelsea forward Tammy Abraham, who ended up joining Swansea. A goalkeeper was away high on Benítez's wish list but, early in the window, a similar failure to close the deal. Saw him lose Manchester City Willy Caballero to Chelsea. Newcastle hierarchy question whether he need a new keeper. Leaving Benítez who had thought that being Juong the title manager as opposed to head coach would confer a certain degree of autonomy feeling let down. If he became alternately patient and disgraced over the board apparent refusal to fully trust his judgment, a general sense of dismay grew as it took almost 2 months at a piece. To complete the signing of Florian Lejeune and Miguel Merino respectively, that was despite the fact that Lejeune contract at AEBA contained an £8.80 M release clause and Merino was arriving on loan from Borussia Dortmund. As a Champions League winning manager who spent Thursday at an elite coach convention in Nyon, Switzerland, Benítez possesses peerless contact but Newcastle peculiarly idiosyncratic modus operandi dictate he is often unable to utilize them properly. Aware the budget would be limited and the squad required pruning he was willing to view and deal this summer but now seem convinced Atlee will never finance an attempt to take Newcastle back into regular European combat. More pressingly, a failure to recruit sufficient new face has left Benítez who only last week was adamant he required at least 2 signings before the window closure needing to repair his relationship with DWI Gele. He had originally planned to sell last season leading scorer but due to the lack of a suitable attacking replacement, Instead ended up keeping him. Similarly, Benítez wanted to send Freddie Woodman, his gifted young England under 21 goalkeeper on loan but has been forced to ask him to stay put and serve as third choice keeper. Individually and collectively it has turned into a summer of waste opportunities with each sending with Newcastle much loved manager booking at what he now relook tally regard as a strictly limited future on tiny side.